All right, so we have 5,000 people working for Lego Group. Look at this next one. A little awesome choice for you. So how many Lego bricks are being made every minute? 13,000, 23,000, 33,000, 43,000 bricks. No matter what, that's a lot of bricks, isn't it? All right, let's see. How many A? How many? 1A?
13,000?
B's?
Sorry.
Gary? Lego bricks being made every minute. All right, now for this next one. On the tables are close to you, there's a little bag of bricks. Here's our next question. Do this. How many ways can you arrange 6 8 studded Lego bricks? How many ways? You take those 6 bricks and you can arrange them. Does anyone want to take a guess? Gary, don't show them. Exact number, but you're way off. Let's show them, Gary. Feel free to grab those Legos and start working on that. We're not leaving until you get them all done, all right? So needless to say, Legos keep us entertained. All right, let's look at some of the creations some people have put together. First one here, all made out of Legos. The next one. The next one. Full-size elephant. I'm gonna draw a gray on one side too. Just curious. And the next one, a full-size car. Look at this. Look at this, the Lego DeLorean my kids got me. And yes, the door's open. Like Mr. Fusion. This is the number one, two, three, four. And let me even the wheels convert to the hovercraft.
That's cool.
Sorry, I don't want to get distracted. I don't know if you've seen this website. It's called The Brick Testament. It is somebody who's taken all the stories of the Bible and using Lego people, recreating them. So that's kind of fun if you want to look to it. And actually, this is brand new. They took all those pictures and they put them into a two-book set. So if you're looking for a unique gift or something for your kids to even adults to enjoy that, there it is. So Lego bricks are all over the place, aren't they? We've played with them. We've done things with them. Great stuff. So Lego bricks. But today, let's talk about Lego bricks. Teach us about relationships. So now it's time to get your pen out and your paper, and we'll take some notes here. So I stuck a little red Lego up in the corner up for some notes, if you want to jot down some notes along the way. So Lego bricks, when we look at it, let's talk about relationships today. The first thing we can talk about is that relationships are connectional. Relationships help us connect, just like Legos connect with each other. New Way is part of the United Methodist Church. The United Methodist Church calls itself a connectional church. So really, if you go from one United Methodist Church to the other, or you stop in one Sunday and see them, you should see a lot of similarities. And it works really neat. Even the sewing bag we're doing is a connectional church, because all the United Methodist churches are creating the sewing kits, and they go together, and then we pass those out as a full-day church, connectional church. And it's kind of interesting the way it works. This has happened a couple of times. My wife and I were headed down to Texas on a trip many years ago, and I didn't know what was around the area or what hotels were good or anything like that. Down to Texas, I think in Austin is where we were headed. So I called, I looked up a church, and I met this church in Austin, Texas. And I said, hey, I happened to get the youth guy when I called the church, and I said, hey, we're coming from Ohio down there. Is there, could you tell me where to stay? And his response was, and this is the connection, he said, well, sure, just come and stay with us. Well, I don't know you. But wasn't that church was very nice to offer? He's like, oh, that's okay. I don't want to look for a place to stay with, you know, him and stuff. I just want to kind of find out. But for him just to be like, hey, oh, you're a United Methodist guy. Yeah, hey, look, why don't you stay with us? Tyler and Amy, who were our worship leaders here, they were taking out a trip out in, I think it was either Washington, Oregon, you know, that area of the country. What's that? Yeah, out there in the woods. And they called me one day while they were out there on vacation, said, Tyler's going into the hospital, he has an extreme migraine, just absolutely almost paralyzing him, it just hurts so bad. So I asked what town were they in and stuff, you know, kind of find out where they were, so I called the United Methodist Church there. I happened to get the pastor who was just heading to the hospital that Tyler and Amy were in. I said, would you mind going out and checking on them for me? He said, yeah, absolutely no problem. They took off right away and they caught them and talked with them. So, and I think, you know, wouldn't that be in a scary situation being that far from home to have somebody come in? And you have a connection there. Our relationships are connectional. So let's look at John 15, 1 through 8. It talks about how not only with each other we're connected, but also with God that we are connected. It says, I am the true vine, my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit. While every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes so that it will even be even more beautiful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me as I also remain in you. Stay connected in me. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. You must remain connected. Right? Our relationship's connected. So even here in our church, we must remain connected. And that's part of my summer challenge of, hey, let's make sure we continue to meet every week together. Because that's part of the connection. And when we don't meet together, that connection, you know, disappears or is lost. So we want to remain there. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. So Legos remind us of our connection with each other, in our relationship, and also our connection with God. Next thing Legos do is relationships create a strong foundation. A strong foundation. So, anytime you find yourself in a new way of life, I know we have some people graduating, heading to college, maybe you're going into a new job, or just working out something. As you look for those people around you who you want to be part of your relationships, make sure they help you create a strong foundation. Make sure they are good for you. Make sure they're good for what you're doing and support you in that strong foundation. Otherwise, the foundation will be weak. When something happens, they disappear. I just saw somebody today talking about fake friends. Have you ever run across a friend who was just, you know, fake? So when something hard came up, they disappeared. You couldn't find them like that. Matthew 7:24 tells us, these words I speak to you are not incidental additions to your life. Home improvements to your standard of living. They are foundational words. Words to build a life on. If you work these words into your life. You are like a smart carpenter who built this house on solid rock. Rain poured down, the river flooded, a tornado hit, but nothing moved. Nothing moved in that house. It was fixed to the rock. But if you just use my words in Bible studies and don't work them into your life, you're like a stupid carpenter who built his house on the sandy beach. When a storm rolled in and the waves came up, it collapsed like a house of cards. So our relationships help us create that strong foundation. And we want the foundation that's going to be able to weather the storms, because they will come in life, right? The storms will hit. Sometimes we get blindsided by them. Sometimes we see them coming. But we have a strong foundation because of the people we've surrounded ourselves with in our relationships. They're going to give us that strong foundation. Relationships create unity. They help create unity. Did anyone see that Legos movie, by the way? Anybody? Couple of it? Well, what's the song that he's in? Everything is awesome when you're part of a team, right? Everything is awesome. Funny story about that movie. We went there, we went to the mass and the place to watch it, and we had the time wrong, so we got in the car and drove just under the speed limit to get us to North Carolina. Made it just in time. But the only seat left in the whole theater was the front row. Oh! I had like at the end, it, like, move your head to see the whole screen. It felt like everything was like close. I watched that thing. I think it was a good movie. I may have blacked out from time. Relationships help us create unity. And if you think about that, we're kind of drawn to the people who like the same stuff as we do. Even in here together at New Way, we create unity as we see a common goal of helping, you know, reaching out to this community and sharing the message of Jesus Christ with people. So, and even if you think about your social media, if you're on Facebook, it says, you might like these friends, or it says something like that, and it's like, you might know these friends, and based on what you like and what you do, it says, hey, maybe you know these people because they're already connected with some of your other friends, and together that helps create unity. So John 17:20, let's look at that. It says, I'm praying not only for them, but also for those who will believe in me. Because of them, their witness about me. The goal is for all of them to become one heart and one mind. So he's talking about unity. Everybody that believes and know Jesus and God and works together. One heart, one mind. Just as you, Father, are in me and I in you, so that they might be one heart and mind with us. Then the world might believe that you in fact sent me. The same glory you gave me, I gave them. So they'll be as unified and together as we are. Here's that word again. Relationships create unity. I in them and you in me. Then they'll be mature in this oneness and give the godless world evidence that you've sent me and loved them in the same way that you've loved me. See, bottom line is that the devil wants to divide and conquer. The devil doesn't enjoy seeing anyone live a happy life. The devil wants to do anything it can to divide and conquer you. All the way down to yourself, within to your family, your extended family, even where you're working at. The devil is a non-stop, just always hammering at people because the devil wants to divide and conquer. So our relationships help us build that foundation and also help us build a unity together so that it's going to be much harder to break that unity. You ever try to peel some of those Legos apart and then you have a whole stack of them trying to find a way to get in there? It's hard to do it. See? But the devil wants to divide and conquer. So relationships, strong relationships help us create unity. All right, the last point here. Let's look at this. Relationships are reliable and compatible. That's the great thing about Legos. One day you can create a T-Rex dinosaur with a Lego. The next day, you can take all those down and build a car out of the same Legos, right? They're reliable, they're compatible, they're flexible. They can do what you want with them, and they can make different things. And that's just an awesome thing to have in our relationships. People that are behind us, that support us, and just do, you know, help us reach our goals and help us live a great life. Relationships are reliable, compatible. That brings us to Ephesians 5:1-2. Says, watch what God does, and then you do it. Like children who learn proper behavior from their parents, mostly what God does is love you. Keep company with him and learn a life of love. Observe how Christ loved us. His love was not cautious, but extravagant. He didn't love in order to get something from us, but to give everything of himself to us. Love like that. So when it comes to our relationships, when we're revived, when we're compatible with each other, we're doing what God has asked us to do and what he's done for us, which is to love. And you see, I like that. He didn't love in order to get something, right? Jesus loved to give us everything. And when we can be friends and relationships that are compatible with that, we can give and love just like that. So that wraps up our talk with Legos. Next time you get them out and you play with them, think of all those relationships about the strong foundation, the unity, the compatibility, their in connection to the how they connect with each other. Right? That's all I have to work for tonight. Dear Lord, we just thank you so much for this time together. We thank you for focusing on relationships and talking about them. You know, relationships can be difficult at times. So Lord, thank you for helping us reconnect about what relationships are and how you've shown us a love that's greater than anything, and how we can love like that. To be there for a friend, or even maybe somebody we don't know, but we can help them out in a way. Lord, we pray that as a group, as a church, we can be that love to this community, to the families in it, to the people who we haven't even met yet. Lord, we want to share that love with people. Help us to love like that. In our relationships this week, Lord, we pray for to open up our eyes and our minds and our hearts to people around us. Maybe somebody we've been struggling with or haven't been able to forgive. That we can do that this week. Lord, maybe, Lord, it's an encouraging word or it's an open ear to listen to somebody who's struggling. Lord, help us be the strong foundation for somebody who needs a strong foundation as we're being tossed in this world. Lord, we know that with you, nothing is impossible. In our relationships, in our lives, our work, our play, whatever, that we can lean on you, that our relationship with you is the foundation that we build everything on. Our friendships, our marriages, our work, just even the way we live. Lord, we ask for your guidance this week. Ask that you lead us, you teach us, take care of us as we go through life. It's in the name of your Son that we do pray. Amen. And our next act of worship is our offering time. The way we do offering here is there's a round, round basket on the table. So if you could pass that around your table, pass the basket around your table, and then extend it to the people sitting in the chairs as well. When your table is done, just bring that on up and set it on the stage here. We're just going to play a little bit of music while we take care of our offering. We'll pray over that, then we'll sing our one last song tonight. Thank you.